That's close. Here we come. I didn't do my makeup this morning.
Kris, can you recall sort of an early meeting with him as a player? We've seen him so much around the room, sitting next to guys on the stools. Any early impressions?
Absolutely. I mean, for me, I'll never forget the first day that I met Ted Lindsay. I walked in. It was my rookie year. I walked into the Detroit Red Wing locker room at Joe Louis Arena, and Ted was already working out. He had this gray T-shirt on, these gray shorts on, and I came up and I introduced myself and we started talking, and you know, and then I'm like, I wasn't quite sure if I should start working out or not because it's Ted Lindsay, and I thought I should maybe let him finish his workout before I started, but the opportunities that we were able to have, you know, all my teammates to walk in and see Ted Lindsay in our dressing room. He just made us better. He made us better people. He made us better hockey players. Just the stories that he told. And, you know, for me, my favorite times were playoff hockey and Ted Lindsay being in the locker room on game day. And it just elevated, you know, our intensity and our emotion. And, you know, obviously when you have a nickname, Terrible Ted, there's a reason for that. And, you know, the one thing that, you know, we talked about is obviously competing and you know, really kind of hating your opponents. And, you know, that was obviously the era that he grew up in, that he played in. And I think a lot of the success and a lot of the way we played was because of, you know, just listening to Ted and some of the stories that he had. And just amazing and very fortunate to be able to, you know, walk into a room, a dressing room, an NHL dressing room, obviously Original Six, Detroit Red Wing, and have an opportunity. Just, you could sit on a stool and have a coffee and talk to a Hall of Famer and a legend like Ted Lindsay. But the amazing thing with Ted is everything that he did on the ice has obviously been applauded, and you know, he's been recognized for that. But everything that he did off the ice, I think, is probably what, you know, Ted would be most proud of what he's done with that, and that just speaks volumes for exactly what Ted Lindsay's all about. And you know, for me, he went to St. Mike's. My dad went to St. Mike's, and I just remember always, you know, my dad talking about Terrible Ted Lindsay. And after I had that first meeting with him, I don't even know if I had a cell phone back then. I had to go into Paul Boyer's room and at Joe Louis Arena, pick up the phone, and I called my dad, and I left him. I had to use his calling card, actually, and I left him a message that I just met Ted Lindsay. And you know, so that was it's a moment that that I'll certainly never forget.
Do you have a favorite moment of him, like before a playoff game or a big game, of just saying a few words or getting you fired up or something like that?
He was at in 97 when we were kind of going through our playoff run. And, you know, I remember, you know, that everyone knows, you know, we're going to play Philly, and apparently Philly was, you know, bigger, stronger and faster, and it wasn't going to be much of a series. And, you know, here we have Ted Lindsay, you know, talking about, you know, don't worry, you know, about the size of them. And he's talking about, you know, our hockey team and how, you know, what we've done and how fast we are and how competitive we are. And, you know, don't worry about the size. You know, this is Terrible Ted Lindsay telling you this. So we actually, you know, we believed him, and everyone obviously knows what happens. But, you know, like I said, to be able to walk into that dressing room and just the opportunity to talk to Ted at those moments and at those critical moments is something that was amazing. And he was, to me, it just shows you, you know, the class of the organization with Mr. and Mrs. Ilitch and obviously Kris now, you know, just allowing, you know, Ted Lindsay to be there whenever Ted Lindsay feels, you know, the right time is to be there. And it's not, I don't think it's like that in every room. I can't speak about that because I wasn't in another organization, but there's times you're walking in and it's Ted Lindsay's there and Gordie's Howe is there. And it's just amazing you know, to be able to walk in, especially when you're playing a playoff game and they have a little story like that to tell you. So those are moments that, you know, very fortunate to be able to do that. And it's just, to me, it's the luxury of playing on an Original Six franchise to walk in and be able to do that, and obviously first class top to bottom.
How do you think he'll be remembered, Kris?
I think he's going to, well, obviously through, you know, all former players with what he did and what he sacrificed for the NHLPA. You know, that's something that every single one of us is very fortunate of what he did. You know, I don't think there's too many men or too many hockey players that would have done what he did back then. You know, standing up for the players, and it just shows you the resolve of Ted Lindsay and the person that Ted Lindsay is. So I think, you know, for a player, the NHLPA is something that we're always going to remember Ted by. I love his nickname, you know, Terrible Ted Lindsay. It's amazing when you start thinking of the great hockey players that have played and the nicknames that they have. You know, you have the great one, which is Gretzky. You have Mr. Hockey, which is Gordie Howe. Magnificent Mario. You got Sid the Kid. You got Mick Jesus. All these great names. And yet we have Terrible Ted Lindsay. And it's one of my, you know, it's probably someone's favorite nickname, you know, with that. So, and then like I said earlier, just everything that he's done off the ice, that he's accomplished, obviously with what he does with autism, his charity golf tournament is something that, you know, every single player that is going to be a Detroit Red Wing is going to play in that. And, you know, they just go there and they just play it. And, you know, the one thing, I think it was about 3 or 4 years ago, we were playing in that out, and it was a really, really hot day. And, you know, it's a probably, you know, five and a half hour round. That's what it is. You know, it's going to be a long day, and you realize that. But when Ted Lindsay asks you, you know, you want to go. You want to be there, and you want to be there to support him. And every time we kind of came back by the first tee, Ted Lindsay was still out there shaking hands. And then after the golf tournament, he's up there. He's got a Bud Light in the hand, and Ted Lindsay's still going, you know. So if he can do it the way he does it, we can certainly do it as well. So you know, a first-class person is how Ted is certainly going to be remembered. And obviously, you know, a feared hockey player, a very competitive hockey player, and then just an outstanding man is certainly how I remember him.
He stayed here for 70 years after he arrived here. But he didn't get to see a winner for like 4 decades, basically, after he won. Was there a connection that you guys felt, your group felt with him, almost like a sense of pride from him when you guys finally got to show him the Stanley Cup?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. I think, you know, the teams that I was fortunate enough to play on, you know, I think we were kind of wired the same way that their team was, you know, just wanted to win the Stanley Cup for a lot of the right reasons. And, you know, I think, you know, when you're able to win a Stanley Cup and then all of a sudden you bring it in the dressing room and Ted's there and Gordy's there, kind of elevates the party a little bit and the feeling that you have. But, you know, there's so many reasons why, you know, our team in 1997 wanted to end that drought. And just to have, you know, and then all of a sudden you start looking at the names on the cup and knowing that your name is going to be next to that and that your name is going to be on the Stanley Cup along with Ted Lindsay and Gordie Howe and obviously the production line and Sawchuk and all the great Red Wings and all the great players of the past, you know, is something certainly, you know, that is very special for a hockey player. But I think, you know, with, like I said, I just can't say enough about how Ted, you know, kind of carried himself and his presence around our hockey team and our organization is, you know, something very special.
Kris, he, as you said, a member of the most famous line in hockey, the production line, but you were also a member of a pretty famous line here in Detroit, the grind line. I mean, yeah. Did he feel a connection that way? I mean, he must have liked, you know, the abrasive style that you guys played with.
Let's not get the production line mixed up with the grind line. I appreciate that. you know what? I kid around with, you know, with Stevie and Shanny, whoever it might be, and, you know, all the great things they did, you know, they don't have a line named after them. So, I mean, that it is pretty special. But, you know, I think I think Ted, you know, did appreciate the way we played the game of hockey. Obviously, you know, myself, Mac, Joey, and Maltz, I think a lot of that had to do, you know, when we put that jersey on, we were obviously very proud of putting on the Red Wing, the winged wheel, you know, and a lot of that has to do with the success and the way that they carried themselves and the way that they played the game. And even though, you know, obviously I've seen highlights of Ted and Gordy and the way that they played, but, you know, for us, that's what we had to do. And, you know, it's, you know, when you have, you know, Ted kind of, you know, grabbing you and talking about a game and how you played and maybe, you know, complimentary of the way that you played. I mean, something like that is going to last a lifetime for you. So those are, you just talk about the fortunate moments that you're able to have as a hockey player and some things that you'll never forget.
Is there a specific piece of advice that he ever gave you, maybe about hockey or your personal life in general?
Well, he told me to keep my head up, and he told me to hit them before they hit me. So, I mean, those are the little things. But, you know, he wouldn't, that's not the way, you know, Ted kind of carried himself around us. He mostly would just talk about his experiences and asking questions, and then, you know, an opportunity, when you have an opportunity to give back, you know, give back. When you have an opportunity to sign an autograph for a younger fan, you know, make sure you stop and sign an autograph for a younger fan. I know the one thing, like, his autograph is outstanding, and I know he was took a lot of pride in that. He's like, well, if I'm going to sign something, I want someone to read it, and unfortunately, mine didn't get to his level. You know, it's just a little thing like that, you know, and it's, you kind of sit back, and it kind of does make sense, you know, when someone wants your autograph, they might as well be able to read it. But that just, you know, that's just Ted, class from top to bottom.
Thanks, Chris. Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.